You walked with me, footprints in the sand, and helped me understand where I'm going. You walked with me when I was all alone, with so much unknown along the way. Then I heard you say, I promise you I'm always there. When your heart is filled with sorrow and despair, I'll carry you when you need a friend. You'll find my footprints in the sand. I see my life flash across the sky. So many times have I been so afraid. And just when I thought I lost my way, you gave me strength to carry on. That's when I heard you say,
Lucilda Robinson, Miss Mom, as we always call her. When she meet her end of this life journey, and we are about to put away the remains, as you know, we are not here forever. We are just pilgrim passing through. Miss Mom has reached her time today. Tomorrow can be any one of us. Okay? We don't know. So all we had to do is prepared. You agree with me? Okay, because the Bible says after death comes the judgment. So let us prepare to meet as when we part from this life.
We have a judgment to face.
Heaven shall be our home. God bless you. We are about to start. I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whoso liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know my Redeemer liveth, and he that stand up the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worm destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Do you hear, brethren? Right, and you hear it also.
Yes, yes.
Praise God. Yes, could you turn to your program? I'm going to sing the opening hymn. When the tide of life is past. When the tide of life is o'er, and we lay our anchor down. Could somebody start for me, please?
When the toils of life are over, and we lay our armor down, and we bid farewell to earth with all its cares. Jerusalem.
from Pastor Mills.
Almighty God, we honor you. And we bow down before you. We are gathered this day, O God Almighty, to put our sister who have depart this life. O God Almighty, as we are in this funeral service, God Almighty, I pray that this is a plan that no one can change, because the Bible says, appointed unto men once to die, but after death then comes the judgment. God Almighty, I thank you for the gathering. I thank you for the people. And I pray, God Almighty, that this will be a warning to each and every one of us that we are not here forever. We are just here for a time. Oh, God Almighty, bless this funeral service. Bless everything that shall be said. That when we leave, we will have that assurance that God is with us. And he promised that he will never leave us nor forsake us, but he will be with us. Bless this funeral service in Jesus' name.
Yes, praise the Lord again, everybody. And this time we have the first lesson. Psalm 91, verse 1 to 12, Natasha Williams Miller.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations.
Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God.
Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, return ye children of men.
For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when he is past, and as a watch in the night.
Thou carriest them away, and which a flood they are asleep. In the morning are like when grass which groweth up.
In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up, in the evening it is cut down and withereth.
For we are consumed by thine sin and anger, and by thy day what wrath are we troubled.
Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance.
For all our days are passed away. In thy wrath we spend our years as a tale that is told.
The days of our years are 70 years, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away.
Who knoweth the power of thine anger, even according to thy fear, so is thy word.
So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Praise God.
Thank you. You have a selection.
Go ahead.
You have a selection by great grandchildren.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we do this song, I would like to read something about my grandmother. Lucilda was born June 9, 1931, to the parents of Clementina Briscoe and Norman Bruce. Lucilda got her early education at the Mountainside Elementary School after which she majored in dressmaking. After venturing into this area, she realized that dressmaking was not her passion. She then developed a passion in crafting. She was the best. Lucilda, Mama, Grandma, as she was affectionately called, loved to see her hands at work. Creating all her luxurious styles were all infallible. Her handicraft natures were cut above the rest. Grandma, Auntie Moon, was an industrious, disciplined woman. She was a hard worker, one who was always independent. Her personality depicts that she loves to work and likes orderliness. She was a loyal, pragmatic, and materialistic. Auntie Moon was very adamant in what she believes in and would never stop until she achieved it. While growing up, she would always remind us of disciplined ways that we must inhibit in our everyday lives. She will always be remembered as the grandmother that raised her eyebrow at us, and immediately we knew what that meant. Her word would always be, "Me no broke pick nobody no." Grandma was very free-handed. She shared with just about everyone in her reach. Lunch money, sugar bun, and many other treats were given to all of us. Grandma, Tita Moon, Auntie Moon, we miss you. We love you. We will never forget all the love you showed us. Grandma, hats off to you. You raised us well. You are everything to us. Rest in peace, Mama. Rest in peace.
A country where no twilight shadows deepen. Unending days where night shall never be. A city where no sun cloud ever gathers. This is just what heaven.
Oh, this is
What a sermon!
Hallelujah!
This song can't be so nice. So when we reach heaven and have these nice songs, what joy it will be! When I'm asking everybody to help sing this song, just before I go to the second lesson, we shall have a grand time in heaven. Come!
Yes. Up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time.
Walking with the angel.
Verse 51 to 58. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptibly. And we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. And this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death,
where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Here ends a portion of God's holy word. Thanks be to God.
Everybody,
praise God.
How much you did here now in
trance? Right, Sister Mills. Some of you don't know who Sister Mills is, pastor's wife. Right.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
At this time she'll be coming.
Amen.
The song in tribute.
Let's praise the Lord, everyone. Let's say thank you, Jesus. Some might say we shouldn't be saying thank you, Jesus, but the Bible says in everything, give thanks. Hallelujah. And you won't have to worry anymore. Down here, my burden's heavy. And with the road so rough and long, sometimes my feet get weary and so sore. But a brighter day is coming. Soon I'll rest on heaven's door, and you won't have to worry anymore. The other shore, all my troubles will be over, and I'll rest forevermore. My eyes will be on Jesus, and my heart will be aglow, and you won't have to worry anymore. My burden's heavy, and the road is so rough and so long. Sometimes our feet get weary and so sore. But a brighter day is coming when I rest on heaven's door, and we won't have to worry anymore. Will be over, and we'll rest forevermore. Our eyes will be on Jesus, and our hearts will be aglow, and we won't have to worry anymore. Someday when life here is over, and I say my last goodbye, and I see my Savior standing at the door, saying, come, my child, you're welcome. Leave all your troubles far behind, and you won't have to worry anymore. No, we won't have to worry. Forevermore, our eyes will
the other shore. All your troubles will be over, and you'll rest forevermore. Your eyes will be on Jesus, and your heart will be aglow, and you won't have to worry anymore. Oh, I won't have to worry when I reach the other shore. All my troubles will be over, and I'll rest forevermore. My eyes will be on Jesus, and my heart will be aglow.
Here is over.
Oh, Jesus.
And we reach that beautiful shore.
Yes.
Praise God. We don't have to worry anymore.
Oh, God.
Not at all.
Nothing to worry about.
Not
praise God.
We're just free.
Thank
praise
you,
God. What a lovely home to be.
Praise
you have to provide and fret about. Let us prepare ourselves.
Praise the name of Jesus.
After the end of this life, we can reach that home. We don't have to worry anymore. At this time we have a remembrance. Simone Wright, Nick, and Gary Wright. Neville.
Let me say good morning to everybody. Good morning, family. Hallelujah. Though it's a sad occasion, we are here this morning to support the family because we are a part of this family. Amen. We're going to do this remembrance this morning, and I pray that our minds will reflect on some of the good things that we experienced when Mama Auntie Mon was alive. Amen?
Amen.
Bless God. Amen. Praise His name. Remembrance for the life of our dear Auntie Mon, 1931 to 2021. Hallelujah. In the early 80s, growing up and getting to know who she was. She was a very hard-working woman, never afraid of any task. She was committed to take care of her family, no matter what she had to do, honestly, in providing for them.
Praise God.
I'll take my time. Praise God. Well, this is the last we are doing for Mama. Praise God. I vividly recall her going to the Ochirayos market, bringing straw work to sell from different people, like mats, basket, etc. In those days, for us as kids, life was not so easy. There was many of us to feed, and there was not enough to eat. However, Auntie Mon make sure she would buy ginger sugar, cheese sticks, sugar bun, and I just can't forget those big breads. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. The big bread them my mama used to buy. See what we are talking about this morning. Can't forget them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Big bread she brought to share on her way home.
Yes.
So she starts sharing from Auntie Lurleen. From Roan Hill, alright.
Yes.
From Roan Hill to Auntie Lurleen house.
Yes.
Who also deceased us. And across to the cut over to Auntie Ivo. That's our house. Over Granny Briscoe. Over gravel.
Yes.
Talk to me now, man.
Yes.
Then to Marcus Pen.
Come on,
hallelujah. Talk over Auntie Dita.
Yes.
Talk to God.
Yes.
Every Friday evening, we would be listening for the great commotion. Auntie Mon a come.
Yes.
As we hear those noise, we will start the celebration chanting, Auntie Muna come, Auntie Muna come, Auntie Muna come, Auntie Muna come. Talk to me. Holding hand in a ring, jumping together. She was like our Santa Claus. Come on, man. Coming to save us from hungry and hunger. For us, it was like Christmas. Talk to me now. Read me, sister.
Yes.
Read up the things then.
Our auntie never have a good laugh without sticking out her tongue. Who remember that? She was our first aunt from our mother's side. And truly, she was a gift to us.
We are balancing things this morning.
After retiring selling straw work, she went straight ahead to Santa Cruz Market to sell. Anything she could find, she would bring it there and sell it. One day I saw her in the market and I said to her, Auntie Moon, it's time for you to go and rest. You have worked as much already. Her reply to me was, with her eyes plucking out of her head, me dear, me tell you something. Me no love hands out. Me love work for me own money. Those memories never left our auntie Moon. When I learned that she got a stroke, she was by Auntie Dita's house. Me and my brother went and we prayed for her. Days after, she started walking again. To God be the glory.
Praise the name
Praise
of the Lord. Amen.
Hear Auntie Moon afterwards. I've got some pity there. They can pray, you see. In the month of July, we went up here to visit her. Our little family link up, as usual. Food, no things. Amen. She said, we're gay, gay there. As soon as he appeared, there was just a radiant smile on her face.
Always.
Auntie Moon, we salute you.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
She did what she could for all of us.
We did what we could done for her. Sleep on, Auntie Moon, and take your rest. Yes. Good night.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Glory! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise God!
Yes, sir.
Praise God!
Please keep the moon. Oh, goodness!
Jesus!
Goodness. Ma Sydney. Ma Sydney.
Yes.
Could you behave yourself, sir? You are making a life. Now I'm looking on my time now. 12:12.
Go ahead, sir.
Pretty early, not you?
Yeah.
And the program almost finished. But my mind tell me somebody here want to say something to get 2 minutes. Did anybody want to say something short before we go further? Anybody? Open up to anybody? Okay, God bless you. So we're going to move on now. To the Elagi.
Yes.
One William. What is the name before?
Puerto Rico.
Okay. I don't want to spoil people's name, you know. So that's why I ask. Granddaughter, Puchico.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Eulogy of the late Lucilda Robinson. The purpose of life is to live a life of purpose. With that said, journey with me as I give you a sneak peek into the life of the late Lucilda Robinson. born on the 9th of June, 1931, to parents Norman Bruce and Clementina Briscoe in the quiet district of Banton Mountainside, where she grew up and attended the Mountainside Elementary School. After school, the industrious Lucilda ventured into dressmaking, where she showed off her skills, creativity, and sense of fashion. Like the beauty of her fashion, she herself was a true beauty. She would often walk past the mirror and took a glimpse at herself, only to return with a broad grin as she uttered, "Me been a pretty girl, you know?" And I would say, "I know, Grandma, I know, it shows." Her beauty and her charisma made her irresistible. It was hard not to love her. Grandma dated and found love along with motherhood. She mothered 8 children, 2 of whom are deceased, Nathan and George. She loved and cared for her children dearly and worked earnestly to take care of them. Through the hills and valleys, she traversed in search of fruits such as mangoes, sweetsop, soursop, ackee, and just about anything, just to name a few, anything that she could get to sell in the market. She would take them to Oxford Street in Kingston. Grandma was a natural creative and a go-getter, so again, she ventured into something new. This time it was basket weaving, or straw work as she would call it. Sales was like second nature to her. She started to buy baskets, fans, pinballs, bread trays, mats from the people in and around her community. Then she would take them to Otreas, where she would sell them on a weekly basis, and so she became the village merchant. In her quest of finding goods for sale, she also found her long and lasting love, her light in shining armor, her true love, Mr. Roy Robinson. Like magnet to steel, the two were inseparable. In the year 1979, they got married and the two became one. Grandma moved to Malvern to be with her husband. The two shared a fun, loving relationship. But as fate would have it, Mas Roy, as he was affectionately called, waved goodbye to his dearest Moon, as he would call her, in the year 2007. Grandma became a widow and a very strong one. Like a warrior, she took up the mantle. By this time, she had stopped trading in Otreas. Knowing her, Grandma was always on the move, so she found something else to do. She started to go to the Santa Cruz market, where she sold thyme, scallion, and carrot, which she produced. Going to the market was something that she loved, as having a sense of independence was very fulfilling to her. She would get up early in the mornings, early every Saturday, every Friday and Saturday mornings, in order to get ready for market. But somehow, somewhere along the line, Grandma would be running late. She would echo repeatedly, "Bashman ta come," which is a taxi driver. So we would have a situation where the taxi is coming and Grandma is still in the house spinning. Nevertheless, she showed up every weekend, but as the saying goes, all good things must come to an end. So yes, people, the time came where she had to hang up her basket and apron, and because her market journey had ended. In spite of not being able to go to the market, Grandma continued farming as a hobby until she wasn't able to do it anymore. As she aged, her health deteriorated, which meant more frequent visits to the doctor. Hence, she was hospitalized on Tuesday, the 12th of January, 2021, and on the fateful day of Sunday, January 24th, Grandma took her last breath and waved goodbye, goodbye. In saying goodbye to our champ, I pause to reflect on how blessed we are to have called her Mama, Grandma, Moon, Auntie Moon, Miss Moon, and the list goes on. She taught us many of life's lessons. She stood for those who were in need. She gave a voice to those who could not speak. She taught us the pleasure of a helping hand, the success of hard work, the importance of cleanliness, the virtue of honesty, the care of kindness, the need to be disciplined, the joy of a moment, the value of prayer, the power of love, the blessing of family, and to always, always carry a spirit of gratitude. As we pull the curtains down on the life that was, ladies and gentlemen, my humble request of us this afternoon is for us to take a page out of Grandma's book. Love without limit. Laugh from your belly. And most importantly, live full and die empty. We salute you, our golden matriarch, the root of our family tree. She will be surely missed by her surviving children, Dita, Dawn, Daron, Danville, Nazbirth, and Angeline. 35 grandchildren, 44 great-great-grandchildren, 2 great-grandchildren, 3 sisters, 2 brothers, daughters-in-law, sons-in-law, and a host of other relatives and friends. Walk good, Grandma. Walk good. Walk good, my quintessential queen.
We understand that you saddest to lose your loved one. And you just cannot move. If you have to cry, you just cry. Well, let me say, I heard the Sheila disease. One of my churches. And sometimes I sit in church and see she's coming through the church with her handbag, you know? And she's coming briskly, you know, to church. But sad to say, we have to miss her. But one thing I can say, we hope to meet again. And I have a song going to sing, and I'm going to ask everybody to help me sing before Pastor take over. And this, when I look at the about what, 90 or how much? 90?
89.
89, yes, 89. That's a very good old age. So many young people died that passed that age. So may God bless her. And one thing I got about, she was baptized in the Pentecostal church, and she was a member there up to her party. Was Sister Rob, Miss Muma Kong. And she always remembers, she and my wife is a good friend, she always greet her. And one time we come to pray to her, and she said to her, you know what, we can't come at you, but don't talk. See them, they have their little secrets. May God bless her and her soul rest in peace. I'm going to help you sing this song. I have heard of a land in the far away land. It's a beautiful home. By the deep
where we never know more. We shall be that free,
be in that free.
In Jesus' name. Pastor.
Thank you, Brother Paul, and praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Could we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Could we praise the Lord, everybody? Can you lift your hand and praise the Lord? Lift your hand and praise Him. He's a good God. He's a good God. He never leave us.
Never
forsake us. Say He will be with us all the time. All the time. This afternoon, we are burying Sister Mom how's everybody, you John Caller? And we're not going to see her again. I hear somebody say she have a beautiful smile.
Yes.
And this picture is not a young picture.
No.
This is an old picture.
Yes.
You see this smile?
Yes.
You see how she look good?
Yes.
Hallelujah. But she's not with us. All we have now is her memory. And there is nothing we can do about it besides put her in the grave. Why are we here this afternoon? Midday. 2 minutes past 12. Why are we here this afternoon? Do you know why you're here? You know, sometimes I like when people talk to me.
Alright, talk to me, make me talk back to you.
Why are we here this afternoon?
To celebrate the life of my grandmother.
And what are we going to do with her after that?
We're going to put her away.
Because we don't going to keep her.
No, we can't.
There's a place where she will remain until the rapture.
Where at rest? There is not.
If you didn't want to preach, you would stay in the church. Do you understand what I'm saying, beloved? The scripture says, I am the resurrection
and the life.
He that believeth in me, though he were dead, let shall he live.
Yes.
She believe in the Lord. She will live. But some of us, you know, business with the Lord. We don't have no time for the Lord. But as sickness take you, Lord Jesus, I begin to feel pain. And after you get through the pain, me and me one man or woman,
yes,
me do what me want to do. You see how I'm limping? I'm going to give you my story. I was painting down the house. There's a tall part that I said I'm going to paint on the brush and the stick and paint it. The next morning, you know what me do? Run to borrow one ladder. Put up the pan with the paint on the ladder. The same speed me go up on the ladder, the same speed me come back down.
The
knee crack, cap. Bus in two. What that tell me that? If I did sick to the first plant, that wouldn't happen. But because me, I try to do it quick, me not in a hospital. What I'm saying, beloved, we are children of God. And as children of God, the Bible says we must walk in the light.
Yes.
The Bible says we are the light of the world.
Amen.
A city that set on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do a man light a candle and put it on a bushel. But you put it on a candlestick,
yes,
we all can see the light.
Yes.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world.
Yes.
And if we are light,
we have to shine.
You have to shine.
Yes.
If the cloud covered the sun, you're not seeing no light. But as long as the sun, the cloud move away from the sun, we're going to have light. And our life is important.
Yes.
Make your decision.
Right now.
Stand in the ways. Seek for the right path. When you find it, walk therein.
Yes.
Listen to me. I threw a word before you.
Go ahead, Peter.
You have to pick your choice. Pick your choice. You have the power of choice to make it up or down. We are at the place called Earth. We will have to make a decision. That decision is between you and God. If you want to make it to heaven, you got to be changed. Change your life. Acknowledge Him as your personal Savior. But that means what you're saying. Every day I'm going to call upon the Lord. You know how long I'm going to call upon Him? You see what that means? I'm not playing a hypocrite. I could be a part of it how many years? And I do a wrong. And I don't repent. So what do you think, Samuel?
Hey,
oh. The whole you know do not know you want to go to heaven. You know what, sir? If I saw it, did I go work? Musician, me would have just wait. If we find out that Jesus will come next week, I acknowledge Him. But me don't know when He will come. So me have to prepare myself. And I when me prepare myself, sometimes there is a doubt. And I have to go back down on my knees and talk to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I see people near and far. And the government said we must wear masks. We must distance ourselves. But what I find out, what is sickness name again?
Corona.
Corona. It is getting out of hand. Every day it's going up and up. I learn or I hear that the government gets some vaccine. Next week! And the most important people that are looking after those people are them folks I get. But tell me something, me sure me I go get it?
But you don't want it. Me personal would not want it. Because don't tell me that. You don't want it.
Alright, when you're done, you talk to your friend. The way, and many people said that the sickness won't be going away now. Honestly, I believe it would be about 6 months. But the past year now. All I have to do is be careful of myself. The government says you mustn't wear your mask on your throat. You have to cover your nose. Cover your nose. You are on a ear. Wear the mask, man. Do what the government say. So much of those sickness wouldn't break out. 400 and odd one day. 300 and odd. 200 and I. Everything spiking up. That means that brother means must prepare myself. Because if I catch it, who tell me that I'm going to live? So I'm preparing myself not to get it. I try to distance myself. But that don't happen. But God make the government make a preparation. Distance yourself. People say no nothing. They don't wear them masks. Them just do what they want to do. Well, do what you want to do. On the heart. But remember the Lord said, for all this, I'm going to bring you into judgment. If you live life that is pleasing in His sight, you will make it. But if you live a devil hell life, a devilish life, you're not making it. You think all of we don't know where we are going if we not change? You see, you have the power of choice to change. Make the choice. In other words, if you are going to say we and something happened, you don't got to come back and run. Well, if you have served God, you have to continue serving. The Bible says you must repent of your sin and baptize in Jesus' name and live a sober life. Get the Holy Ghost. The Bible says only that which comes from heaven will go back up. You want to go to heaven? Look in your life. See how you live. If your life is pleasing in the sight of God like Sister Mom, some of you never have been baptized. You got church and pastor, sprinkle the water in your head when you don't know yourself. A child. And you tell me that you're baptized. Baptized, immerse under the water and come up. We need that touch from God. Beloved, all what we are saying and all what we are doing, if we don't live the life that God wants us to live, we ain't gonna make it. You want to go to heaven when you die? Or you want to cart up with him? Not all going to see death, you know. Not all going to have death. Some will be caught up. The Bible said the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we who remain shall be caught up. And not everybody are going to caught up. And not every dead are going to raise. But you have the power of choice. Choose life. The Lord bless you.
Praise
the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
I've heard enough, even nation. God's word stands sure. I keep holding on to Jesus. I keep holding on to Jesus. I keep holding to His blessing in His hand. Though I cannot see the way. Family members, thank God. Evangelist Polly come to pray for the family. I keep holding
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise God. Let us bow our heads in prayer and I pray for the family members of Sister our Father, and our God, our great Creator, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, Lord Savior, we honor you this morning. We give you thanks, we give you praise for your goodness, for your mercies, your favor, your compassion towards us, Lord. We thank you, God, that you are the Lord of Lords. So we here in this gathering, mighty God, as we celebrate the life of our mother, auntie, sister, oh God, whatever relative, God, we give you thanks for her life. And Father, I'm standing now before you on behalf, God, of every family member of earth, Lord. Lord Jesus, you know the number, name, and wish. Father God, we know, Lord Jesus, what death is like, oh, God. Because when you were on the earth, you experienced the same condition, situation, mighty God. And Father, you know, God, it's not easy to take, Lord, when a loved one, oh God, have passed on. But Lord Jesus, we know that you are our strength. God Almighty, we rest in you, Jesus, because you give us comfort. So Lord, I commit, oh God, these family members to you, Lord Jesus, Savior. God, I pray, Lord Jesus, as we have read and listened, oh God, to her behavior during her lifetime, mighty God. I pray, God, for each of them, Lord. As was Lord Jesus encouraged earlier, Lord God, that we take a leaf out of her book. I pray, God Almighty, for each member. Lord Jesus, Savior, God, that you bless them, that you guard them, that you, Lord Jesus, cover them under your blood. Mighty God, help them, Lord Jesus, Savior, to acknowledge you as our Lord and Savior. Lord Jesus, we look Jesus to you, Lord God. We pray, God Almighty.
Hallelujah.
No life, God, is a life worth living except a life living for
blessed
you. Somebody asked the question, why, what am I living for if not for you, Jesus? Lord God, I pray, God, that you help them to realize, Lord God, that Lord Jesus said that you have us in this world. Our duty, oh God, is to serve you. Because the word of God declare, Lord, God Almighty, the whole duty of man is to fear God and keep his commandments. I pray, God, that you help them, Lord, to take heed to your word, mighty God. Surrender their will to you. They have not yet done so, Lord Jesus, Savior. And God Almighty, their lives, oh God, will be worthwhile living. Father, I pray that you bless their going out and their coming in. I pray, God, in this time, Lord Jesus, that we're living in, God, cover them, Jesus. Cover their homes, mighty God. Cover the vehicles, God, in which they may travel. Lord Jesus, Savior, we are here, they are, be with them, Lord God. And Lord, we give you thanks this evening. Sanctify their hearts, mighty God, and cause them, Lord Jesus, to be true worshipers of you. Bless everyone, we pray, as we ask these mercies in your blessed name. And we say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Final session now.
Yes.
Could you turn your ring key? Some glad morning we shall be Jesus in the prayer.
You
are ready to do it.
You
can go up.
Where's the mama?
We shall see Jesus in the heaven.
already inside already. No one there in there. Yeah, the front already inside. All right, stop here, sir.
Stop.
And it cut down like a flower. To fleet as it were a shadow and never continue one day. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom do we seek for, but of thee, O Lord, who our sins are justly free. Yet, O Lord, most holy Father, most holy merciful Savior, deliver us and keep the pains of eternal death. Your nervous Lord is sick of our heart. Shut that thy merciful face to our prayer. But spare us, Lord, most holy, O most mighty God, O holy, merciful Savior. Though most worthy, judge eternally, suffer us not at the last hour, for any pain or death may be far. For as much as I please Almighty God, in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our dear sister, I therefore now commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ash to ash, dust to dust. Looking for the general resurrection. Looking for the general resurrection of the last day. And the life of the world shall come through Jesus our Lord, whose second coming is glory. We shall give him their dead, and the corrupt bodies of those who sleep in him shall be healed, and make like unto the glorious body, according to the mighty work whereby he is able to submit from all.
Thank you.
Thank you. I lay me down. Heaven, hear me now. I'm lost without a cause. After giving it my all, winter storms have come and darkened my.